Welcome to this session. This is to share our knowledge regarding the reasons of failure of apple sleep, the wear out mechanisms, and the methods for improvement of apple sleep life and the role of MGO in the mix for apple sleep compositions in improving the life of apple sleep. When we face with a low apple sleep life, we generally assume that the failure is due to low MGO content. Apple sleep is actually a McCarbon product. So even if the MGO content is 80 to 90%, even then we assume that the failure is due to low MGO content. But actually the apple sleep life depends on a number of factors, which are the points of discussion. A low life of apple sleep involves frequent shutdown of the converter, hampering productions, as well as damaging the whole converter refractory. Apple life is limited. Why? Because of its gradual wear with use. So the apple sleep life depends mainly on the wear rate. It may so happen that the wear crosses a limit when the tapping time is very low, even lower than the specified time according to the design. It may so happen that the dart plug may not sit in the hole to prevent the slack flow inside the channel. Sometimes the damage is so severe that it may damage the surrounding blocks, that means the mother blocks. Sometimes it happens the premature cracking of the apple sleep. This may be due to the poor thermal shock resistance, or maybe due to the stress developed on the inner channel by the steam of the molten metal. It is really difficult to diagnose the cause of cracking. Now, what are the reasons of failure? Apple sleep in operation is subjected to severe thermal shock during tapping and down period due to thermal fluctuation. So poor thermal shock resistance leads to failure, or because of corrosion of MGO grains, because of its low oxidation resistance or low corrosion resistance, or the failure may be due to low abrasion resistance because of severe abrasion by the stream of hot molten The main wear mechanisms is the oxidation of carbon of this McCarbon product, which generally occurs at a temperature above 600 degrees centigrade by reducible oxides like ferrous oxide FeO or manganese oxide MnO, or by the highly oxidized steel prevailing there. In the second steps, chemical corrosion of this MgO, when graphite is oxidized, the slag repelling properties of the product is lost. Now slag can easily penetrate into the product and can reach the grain boundaries and react there with the dense silicate phases present there and forms low melting compounds. So the binding capacity of the matrix of the MgO grains is weak. Now slag can easily eliminate small crystals or crystallites from the crystalline structure and can easily dissolve into it. In the third step is the erosion by the molten steel or slag flow. Because that time the overall structure is weak and that can be easily eroded. It has been found that at the hot phase, a reduced layer of magnesium oustite below the slag layer, which protects the carbon of the mag carbon product below it. How we can improve the tadpole slip life? The improvement in tadpole slip life depends on the right selection and grading of raw materials, use of technologies for production, and by design of the slip, like cylindrical design. That means throughout the same diameter of the inner channel of the slip, or funnel like top at the hot phase, that is inside the converter and attached with a cylindrical channel, or a conical design, that is high diameter at the inlet, that is inside the converter, and less diameter at the outlet point, that is outside the converter. Thus, by customizing the flow of steel through the tadpole slip with an aim to minimize the turbulence by controlling the flow of steel and pressure distribution through this tadpole slip design. The improvement in quality for durability depends on repeated trial and error and customizing the product for a particular unit. Also, thickness of the slip plays an important role in improving the durability of the slip. When slip thickness is relatively less, that means 70 mm or less, attention is to be given on the strength of the product. That means composition is to be such that the strength of the product is in higher side. Keeping metal powder as antioxidant in higher side. With the use, the slip thickness will be reduced, and then the strength of the remaining thickness is not sufficient to sustain the stress imparted by the molten steel on the wall of the slip channel. But when the slip thickness is more, that means more than 70 mm, then attention should be given priority basis on the thermal shock resistance. That means composition should be such that the thermal shock resistance of the product is in higher side by increasing the carbon content. So the material design has to be continuously changed in response to the slip thickness. Now we shall discuss here about the composition and function of different components and change of different qualities by its compositional change. MgO is the main aggregate in the composition and is used in the range of 80 to 95%. MgO has a direct relation with the use of fused MgO grain in the composition and also in the crystal sizes. In fused MgO, CaO-SiO2 ratio should be above 2:1. When it goes below, the product like C3MS2, that means 3CaO MgO 2SiO2, and CMS, that means CaO MgO SiO2, both having low melting point about 1500 degree centigrade, are formed. When the above ratio is above 2, then the product formed is C2S and C3S, that means 2 CaO SiO2 and 3 CaO SiO2 are formed, which results a product which has a melting point around 2100 degrees centigrade. This is required to ensure mechanical strength. So CaO SiO2 ratio should be well above 2:1 to ensure high refractiveness of the fused MgO, say 2.3:1. In fused MgO, the pericles grains are very large and have well developed cleavage cracks, for which the spalling resistance of refractories is superior. With the use of electrofused MgO grain, the wear rate is decreased and the penetration is low. The reason for that is assumed to be the narrow grain boundaries in between MgO grains. That means there is little amount of silicate phases in between grains, and there may be direct MgO-MgO contact. Moreover, larger crystals can tolerate the penetration. We know that electrofused MgO grain has higher BD than sintered MgO. This indicates that the number of pores and the size of the pores allowing slug penetration is less with the electrofused MgO grain. Larger crystal as high as 2000 millimicron is also used in some of the products. Now we know that the MgO content in the mix varies from 60% to 95%. If the MgO content is less than 60%, then the corrosion resistance will be insufficient. Now if the MgO content is more than 95%, then the graphite content in the mix will be limited, and that may be insufficient to provide sufficient thermal shock resistance. In the product, MgO grains forms the aggregate 1 to 4 mm, graphite and finer MgO particles, that means MgO particles having size 10 millimicron to 500 millimicron, acts as filler or matrix. High degree of matrix fillings and homogeneous distributions of fine and microfine MgO and carbon containing compound increases the microstructure density, which leads to the durability of the slip. The finer MgO particles having size less than 10 millimicron should not be used, or if it is used, it should not be more than 5%, it should be less than 5%. If the finer MgO particles having size less than 10 millimicrons is used in an amount more than 5%, then the chance of chemical reactions of these finer MgO grains with the oxides that are formed by the oxidations of metallic powder which are added as antioxidants because of the high reactivity of the finer MgO particles. This may result in the excessive densifications of the matrix that results in the low thermal shock resistance of the product. In the fused MgO grain, generally MgO content varies from 96% to 99%, but from the commercial point of the product, generally MgO content 97% is used in the mix. It has been established by experiment that higher the percentage of fused MgO in the mix, higher is the corrosion resistance of the product. MgO crystals size varies from 150 millimicron to 1000 millimicron and as high as 2000 millimicron. The larger crystals, which generally we talk about, that means the crystals which are having the sizes more than 500 millimicrons. Hope this technical information will be useful. In the next video, the function of other ingredients other than MgO present in the mix for TAFOL slip composition will be discussed. Thank you.